Today we are going to learn how to submit a defect when you are integrated with an ALM system. An ALM system is an application lifecycle management system. This means that it could be a system like Jira, version 1, or Rally. There are a lot of different systems that have a native integration right inside your qTest environment. Today, we are going to use the project that I have integrated with Jira. Additionally, if you are using another system that is integrated in qTest, the steps will be the same and the outcome will be the same. So we're going to start in our test execution section. In this section, we are going to find a test run and we are going to run the test run and submit a defect. So first, when we look in our test execution section, we can go to a release cycle or suite and locate the individual test run. I already have a test run here selected, and this is my execution history, so all of the executions that I have done already on this individual test run. I have the ability to do a quick run or run using TestPad. Typically, when you're executing a single run or more than one test run, you will use TestPad, which will open up in a new window. So this is the method that we will go through today. Here, it's asking me which version of the test run I'd like to execute, so I'm going to stick with the currently selected version and hit OK. The window will open up in a separate tab, and you can see here, this is my TestPad. TestPad is essentially a notebook next to your computer which allows you to jot down the results from each individual step in the test case from which you created your test run. For today, we're going to focus on defects. So we can say an individual step has failed, or we can say that all of the steps have failed. For this example, we'll select all of the steps, come to set status, say failed, and we'll mark the selected steps. Now we have the ability to add the defect here, this bug symbol. We can do that at the individual step or submit the defect. As all of our steps have failed here, we're going to go ahead and submit the defect in the upper right corner. Now we will select new defect. If we were linking an existing defect to this failure, we could type in the defect ID here and hit link. In today's example, we're focused on creating new defects. In my project here, as discussed, I am integrated with an ALM system. Specifically, I am integrated with Jira. When you go to your integration settings, you have the ability to integrate more than one project inside your qTest project. So I can have multiple projects within Jira that I can select for my defect to go. This is an important step as this tells you that your defect will be created inside that system. So technically the defect is not being created inside qTest. If you were not integrated with an ALM system or if that ALM system was not integrating the defects, then the defect itself would be created inside qTest. For this example, the defect is going to go inside Jira. And I can select either one of these projects, and I will keep the selection here and hit Add. Now, this screen that is popping up is part of the browser plugin integration that you must install when you are integrating your project with an ALM system. This is a best practice as the integration browser plugin allows you to open up your window inside your Jira or version 1 or Rally environment. So I have the ability here of creating this defect based on all of the different fields that are inside my Jira project. Please note that in order to use the browser plugin and submit the defect directly inside Jira, You must be logged in and have a user inside your Jira environment or ALM system. So here for this example, we're going to create this defect and we're just going to say that it is a failed step. Note that all of the steps that I had inside this individual test run was brought over into my description section. And I can complete the rest of the fields inside my ALM system looking at this screen right here. Another advantage is that I'm able to directly assign this defect to anybody that is inside my ALM project. So I am not in qTest at this moment. I am not assigning a person to this defect that's inside my qTest project. I'm looking at all of the users that are inside my Jira project. I can continue to fill out the rest of the fields here inside this view. And when I'm done, I simply hit create. Please note that the window closing itself is the correct integration from Jira to qTest or from your ALM system to qTest. So here, what you'll notice is I have my defect ID. So this is the defect ID from my ALM system, and it has been automatically attached here inside my test run. This screen allows me, if I would like, to create additional defects or link additional defects to this test run, but I am done, so I will X out of this. Most importantly, when creating a defect in qTest, you want to be sure to save your results. So in one system, in my ALM system, I have created a defect, but in qTest, I have not saved that defect to this individual test run. The most important step here before I am complete is to hit save, and now both systems will be linked to each other in terms of this defect. The last step that I can do to verify that the defect that I just created is linked and correct in qTest is I can go back to my defect and I have the ability to actually see this qTest defect inside my ALM system and the linked issues that were brought in from qTest. This is the full end-to-end view of how to create defects when integrated with an ALM system. I hope you found this training helpful, and for more information on creating defects or working inside qTest, please visit our Academy YouTube channel.